With sighs of woes Thank you. such anxiety. Could the bad case what I endure, or could I tell you how all of us would for a while the sorrow cease, a little cease, and listen for a while to my lamenting of grief to sensible. I know your tender nature. Well, I remember what I offer sought to call disdainful semi. When I with scorn have been rejected, your tuneful voice my tale would tell in pity of my sad despair, and with which melody compel attention from the flying fair.
To when I see it, I will not understand me. Whence could proceed such tenderness, when such compassion, insensible, ingrate? Ah, no, I cannot blame thee. For my facts unknown before, who could the hidden cause explore, or think that love could act so strange a part to plead for pity in a rival's heart?
Ah me, what have I heard? She does her passion harm.
What had I not expect? You never should have known. No, never should I have
Thank you.
the road, still thou tedious and slow look, where Cythero proudly stands, Boeotia parting from Cecropian lands. High on the summit of that hill, beyond the reach of mortal light, by Jove's command and Vulcan skill, behold the new erected Pallas rites.
Sit and hear through the ocean lake, a tranquil cheek, the sun does I compel his downy bed to leave, and silent cell with noise and light I will his peace modest, nor shall he sink again to pleasing rest till to my bow relate he grants supplies and seals with sleep the wakeful dragon's eyes.
Pangs of absence, since you have formed my soul for life. sighs, my simile, what gentle songs well I soft I tremble those her eyes in interrupted light, where a bobbing for a vent amidst the doomed fight. Some new fun wish appears, speak and obtain.
At my own happiness I sigh and tremble. Mortals whom gods affect have their own limits set to life, and cannot long be blessed. Or if they could, a god may prove inconstant.
Beware of jealousy. Had Juno not been jealous, I'd e'er had left Olympus, the one that in my love.
I need a spear's remove.
this instant, two winged zephyrs from her downy bed, thy much-loved Ionair, and both together waft her ether to the balmy air.
Shall I my sister see, the dear companion of my tender years?
See, she appears but sees not me, for I am visible alone to thee. While I retire, haste and meet her, and with welcomes greet her, while all this scene shall to Arcadia turn, the seat of happy nymphs and swains, fair without a ray of jealousy they burn, and taste the sweet of love without its pains.
Oh,
it like evil beneath a shell deceiver. And in this mirror she says, see, herself is not transformed as me. Do I some goddess see, or is it Samory? Dear sister, speak, whence this astonishment? Your charms improve him, all the divine perfection. Sure you were late admitted among celestial beauties. As Jove consented, then I obey immortal. Oh no, I still am mortal. Or am I sensible of any change or no
Thank you. Like dove, like dove. Thank you.
sing, and they must sing guys. With joy, shall I walk, shall I walk, shall I walk, and I'll walk again. And once for my rival and music free. The sweets of revenge make it move for to rain, and heaven will it after be heaven indeed. And heaven will it after be heaven indeed. The sweets of revenge make it move for to rain, and heaven will it after be heaven indeed.
And I did as if from me flowed.
that Jove ordained I Athamas should wed.
In Jove, in everything obey.
Unworthy of your charms, myself I yield. Be Jove's command, and yours fulfill.
See, from above, the belling clouds descend, and big with some new wonder, this way turn.
Love's reigns at an end.